गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ ग्रेड सेवन एंड आई एम ब्लेसिंग यू अगेन विद ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर टू इनसाइड आवर अर्थ. द प्रेजेंट टॉपिक से रॉक्स एंड मिनरल्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स यू नो दैट द अर्थ क्रस्ट इज मेड अप ऑफ सॉलिड मटेरियल्स. That is called rocks that constitute only 1% of its weight. Rocks vary in color, texture, chemical composition and softness. You know very well that the main constituents of rocks are known as minerals. Okay? Granite is made up of several minerals and like mica, quartz, feldspar and these are the main constituents of rocks. Granite. Minerals are naturally occurring substances. And also these are inorganic substances made up of more one or more elements. So how can you define minerals? Minerals are naturally occurring inorganic substances which are made up of more or one or more elements are known as minerals. And you can say in another way also, the naturally occurring inorganic substances which are made up of one or more elements are known as minerals. Minerals have definite physical and chemical composition. Most minerals have a crystalline structures and we can find different types of minerals inside the earth, in the rocks. They are metallic and non-metallic, coal, petroleum, iron ore and several others are the examples of minerals. The size of crystals varies from one region to another because it depends on the conditions under which the rocks form. The term ore is very popularly as the geographical term. So you can define ore as the rocks from which we can extract minerals are known as ores. As you know that minerals have definite physical and chemical compositions, but rocks do not have definite chemical compositions. Some rocks contain metals in large quantities, some rocks are very hard, some rocks are very soft. Marble is the hardest minerals and soap stone is the softest. Marble that is used to build Taj Mahal and soap stone is used to make talcum powder. So there are various types of minerals found in the rocks. Hematite is an ore of iron. So some rocks like granite and marble are used for constructions and these types of rocks found in an area determine the type of landform, drainage or soil. Types of rocks, this is very crucial topics. Types of rocks. Dear students, There are three important types of verbs. They are first igneous rocks, second sedimentary rocks, and third metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are known as primary rocks because all other rocks are formed from igneous rocks. That is, these rocks are also known as parent rocks. Igneous rocks are known as parent rocks and primary rocks because all other rocks are formed from igneous rocks. It is formed due to the volcanic eruption. When lava or magma comes out after the volcanic eruption, they remain either inner side of the earth or on the surface of the earth. The magma that is solidified on the surface of the earth is known as extrusive igneous rocks, and the lava that is formed rocks inside the earth after solidification are known as intrusive rocks. Igneous rocks are two types. They are extrusive igneous rocks and intrusive igneous rocks. The rocks that cool below the surface of the earth are known as intrusive, and the rocks that cool on the surface of the earth are known as extrusive. So there are two types of igneous rocks. Intrusive and extrusive. Intrusive rocks are formed below the surface of the earth, and extrusive rocks are formed on the surface of the earth. The crystals of intrusive rocks are bigger in size than extrusive rocks because it is solidified very slowly. Therefore, the crystal of these rocks form bigger in size, and the extrusive rocks, that is, when lava solidifies on the surface of the earth, they cools down very rapidly. So the crystals of extrusive rocks are very fine. Second, sedimentary rocks. It is the second layer of rocks after igneous rocks. Sedimentary rocks are formed after the weathering of igneous rocks. Weathering is an important geographical term. You have to know about weathering. What is weathering? Weathering is the Weathering is the geographical term, and you can define it the breaking of rocks due to excessive heat and pressure is known as weathering. Due to the process of weathering of igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks are formed. And both igneous and sedimentary rocks are converted into metamorphic rocks due to excessive heat and pressure inner side of the earth. So these are three important types of rocks. They are igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are of two types, intrusive and extrusive. Intrusive igneous rocks are formed below the surface of the earth, and extrusive rocks are formed on the surface of the earth. The crystals of intrusive rocks are bigger in size because the lava that is solidified in the inner side of the earth surface is solidified very slowly, so the crystal of intrusive rocks form as bigger in size, and extrusive igneous rocks are formed on the surface of the earth, and the crystals of extrusive rocks are very fine, very thin. Sedimentary rocks, second, after the weathering of igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks are formed. It is the second layer of rocks after igneous. And then both igneous and sedimentary rocks are converted into metamorphic rock due to excessive heat and pressure inside the earth. So, the topics of today, rocks and minerals and types of rocks, have been completed accurately. And I will provide you some more questions today from this chapter, including one or two, perhaps. The topics of today has finished already. So, I will meet you in next class. Thank you.